Today with James Bishop, Manager of Product Marketing for TELUS Consumer Solutions. I'm going to talk about Android and really what about their strategy is and why some devices are staying where they are, the purpose of getting upgrades. So what is TELUS's philosophy on Android and future plans?
Okay, so when our philosophy on Android in particular is we like to have lots of different platforms, lots of different offerings. It's all about our client. We want to make sure that all the different clients that we have are going to have the different needs they might have met. So when we talk about Android and the platforms and upgrades specifically, we understand that our clients' lifestyles change. You know, they get used to a phone, they want more from it, they want more power, more capability, so we want to give that to them. You know? Right. So the way we look at the platform upgrades is we want to make sure that as our clients' lifestyles change, that as more platforms come out, Android 2.1, 2.2, as the case may be, when it went from Claire to Froyo, that we're going to continue to meet those for our client.
Right.
Our clients should be able to get that same access from that same Android power quickly.
Right. So when a device comes out, let's say the HTC Desire, that came out at 2.1, just recently came out at 2.2, how come the time in between was a little bit longer than usual? How come that happens?
Well, it depends what you mean by usual. You know, so I don't know that there is a usual there.
Correct.
For the most part. So there's a number of different factors that come in there. The manufacturer, HTC in this case, needs to have the software delivered from Android, from Google. They need to work on it, make sure it works on their platform, make sure all the bits and pieces, the Lego bits of the technology fit together. HTC delivers to us, we get all that software, we make it work on our network, but we're not going to release it until it works.
Right.
You know, because that's the most important stuff for us.
Right.
Even though we want to get it quickly, we want to make sure it gets there quickly, but in a way that works really well for our clients.
Correct.
We don't want it to have bugs. We don't want them to have a negative experience. We want to get it fast and we want to get it good.
Right. So other devices, like the Backflip, that's not going anywhere. How come that is? Is that from a TELUS standpoint? Is that from a Motorola standpoint for the best experience?
That's a technical specification. So there's hardware specifications that need to be met to support different levels of the platform. So to go from 1.6 to 2.0, if that's the upgrade path, there's certain hardware specifications that need to be there that the device may not have.
Right.
You know, so I don't know the exact specifics on the Backflip, but if we're not upgrading something, that's because there isn't a path available. We'll
okay.
upgrade as many devices as we can, as often as we can, even for ones that aren't in market, like the HTC here. We're not actively selling it anymore, but we're still going to continue to upgrade it as far as we can, so our
okay.
clients can still get that experience.
And something like the upcoming Fascinate, which will be launched soon,
yep.
You've already stated that will be upgraded to 2.2 this coming winter.
It will be, yes. Didn't interrupt you, but yeah, we do have an upgrade path for it. It's hard to say a specific date just because
right.
with all those different moving pieces, but we've got a pretty firm idea that, it'll be this winter. Samsung's committed to us that they're going to have the software, so as soon as we have it, we'll put it to market as well.
And is that something you'll be doing for every device that has Android on it? You're going to say, hey, this is launching with this OS, but it will be upgradable to this.
If we know it at launch, we'll communicate that at launch. Not all devices will know from the manufacturer if we'll have that upgrade path at launch, but it does come back to the way we pick our devices as well. Something that we've been learning through the last year now, it has been, of having Android devices, is some are better than others to pick. Part of what we're really trying to do is pick the right phones. So making sure we're picking the right devices that do have those upgrade pathways for them. So we have a couple that aren't. You mentioned the Backflip. It's a great phone that we love. We're going to make sure we pick phones that do have upgrade pathways. So that's why you've seen some choices that we've made or not made that stand out. So take the Samsung Tab, the tablet. We've chosen consciously not to take it because it doesn't have an upgrade path that we know. That Google has said, hey, Android 2.1, it's not optimized for a tablet. You know, we want to make sure that it's going to be either Gingerbread or Honeycomb that
right.
comes after that's on the tablet, that Android's saying, this is optimized for it.
Right.
So that comes down to some of the choices that we made too.
Okay. So that's one way you pick Android devices. How are some other ways you choose an Android device to have in your lineup?
There's a couple different ways, price point being one of
okay.
them. We see phones like the Desire and the Optimus One. That
right.
are both in market. Both of
right.
those, great phones. There's a fit and finish difference. There's a performance difference. There's a price point difference. It has
right.
to do with the needs of our customers as well. Not everyone wants to buy the super high-end device.
Right.
So we want to make sure there is something there for everyone. Form factor, another one. We've seen some interesting form factors, the Moto Charm, the Backflip,
right.
the Desire, you know, a number of different form factors that we want to make sure there's choices for our clients.
Hey, you have a lot of Android devices. I think you have probably the most with any Canadian carrier.
I haven't counted specifically some of the others in a while. I'm not sure what Rogers or Bell has come in and out of market. We certainly put a lot of commitment into it because we recognize that there's something
this there. This is the way to go, yeah.
And I think we were definitely one of the first in Canada to really put a stake in the sand with Android to say, hey, yep, here's something important that we want to make sure the public knows about, that our staff are well trained on to make sure that clients can get a really good idea of what it is before they buy. It's part of what we come back to as well, of not just picking the right phones, but making sure our clients understand what they are so they're picking the one that's right. Best.
And do you think Canadians know about Android and what its capabilities are?
I think it's getting better.
Yep.
You know, I mean, when it first came out, like anything, there's an adoption curve. But I think certainly the way other carriers are, I hate to say, copying us in some ways, but I've seen other stores that are starting to see robots in the window that aren't TELUS. I think people are picking up on the cues that there's something there.
Right. Right. Good. Okay. Thank you.